Peril by Bertrand Russell. Man's Peril is one of Russell's best known short essays and the most celebrated of his many talks for BBC Radio. Peril means serious and immediate danger. He discusses man's peril from the hydrogen bomb. In this essay, he highlights. Let's know about Bertrand Russell. He was a British philosopher, a professor of philosophy, a writer, and public speaker. His famous books, War Crimes in Vietnam, The Principles of Mathematics, and famous essay, Why I Am Not a Christian. Why I Am Not a Christian is a talk given by Bertrand Russell, and he was jailed for anti-war views in 1918 and in 1961. He received Nobel Prize in Literature in the year 1950. Let's see what are the key points to remember in this essay. In this essay, Russell talks about disasters of war and future of human race. He expresses his concern for human race, and he begins his speech by saying he is speaking not as a Briton, not as a European, but as a human being. He says man's life is in danger. Human race life is in danger. He discusses the consequences of war, especially with hydrogen bomb. Russell appeals to the world nations, to the countries, to understand the peril, to understand the danger in future in war with the hydrogen bomb. And he exhorts to put aside our conflicts, to put aside countries' conflicts, because the world is full of conflicts. There is a conflict between Jews and Arabs, Indians and Pakistanis, white and black, and communist and non-communists. So world is full of conflicts. He exhorts all the nations to put aside their conflicts and work collectively for world peace. All equally are in peril, and if the peril is understood, there is hope that all the countries may collectively stop the war. So Bertrand Russell says that the general public and the people in authority, or men in authority, have not realized the consequences of war with the hydrogen bombs, because hydrogen bombs are more powerful than atom bombs. The world has already witnessed Second World War with atom bombs, and there was mass destruction, and it destroyed two cities in Japan. So he says that the world, the common people and the men in authority, that means rulers, have not realized the consequences of war, the results of war. Hydrogen bomb is more powerful than atom bomb. In World War II, there was an atom bomb raid on two cities of Japan. On August 6th, 1945, an atom bomb was dropped on Hiroshima. And on August 9th, 1945, another bomb was dropped over Nagasaki in Japan. So there was a mass destruction, and one hydrogen bomb could destroy larger cities such as London, New York, Moscow. With atom bomb could destroy a city like Hiroshima, but one hydrogen bomb could destroy big cities like London, New York, and Moscow. Bikini Atoll, a coral reef in the Marshall Islands of USA, USA conducted the nuclear testing program. It detonated 23 nuclear weapons during 1946 and 1958. It is very clear with the Bikri test that a bomb can now be manufactured which will be 25,000 times more powerful. It radioactive particles will be emitted from the hydrogen bomb and they gradually spread destruction over a much wider area. The radioactive particles, they are lethal radioactive particles, mix with the air and in the environment, it causes much harm to human beings. Not only human beings, it causes much harm to animals and plants, to all living beings. If many hydrogen bombs are used, there will be universal death. So here in this essay, Bertrand Russell appeals world nations to work for peace, and if they think they can avoid or stop the war, if there will be a war with hydrogen bomb, there will be a universal death. Many warnings have given by eminent scientists and military strategists. Here, Sir John Slessor, an Air Force expert, said a world war in this day and age would be general suicide. Russell puts two questions: shall we put an end to the human race, or shall mankind renounce war? So here, it is very difficult to abolish war. Why it is very difficult to abolish war? Because the abolition of war will demand distasteful limitations of national sovereignty. The people hope that war may be allowed without nuclear weapons, without using nuclear weapons. If nuclear weapons are used in the war, there may be mass destruction, and the bombs exterminate all life on planet. It destroys big cities. So Russell appeals nations and superpowers, wealthy nations, the nations which manufacture atom bombs and hydrogen bombs, not to use nuclear weapons in the war. And Russell fears that the treaty on non-proliferation of nuclear weapons may not work once the war breaks out. Once the war breaks out, the countries are superpowers, are powerful nations, start manufacturing bombs, and other countries which do not manufacture bombs may suffer a lot. Naturally, the countries which manufacture bombs and use them in the war will win in the war. So he thinks that, and he fears that, these countries do not bind to the agreement on not using or non-proliferation of nuclear weapons. Russell speaks of the role of the neutral countries. Neutral countries have to play a key role in preventing the nuclear war. Neutral countries or neutral governments have to bring opposite sides, powers of opposite sides, and try to see that they make an agreement for peace, and try to see that they should not use nuclear weapons. So if the war breaks out, all the inhabitants of neutral countries along with rest of mankind will perish. So here Russell says that there are so many issues between nations. between countries, political issues, religious issues, border issues, but those issues should be resolved peacefully. The issues must not be decided by war. Here he likes to see a commission of experts appointed by neutral powers to draw a report on the destructive effects to be expected in a war with the hydrogen bombs. So he appeals all the nations, especially neutral countries, to avoid war with hydrogen bombs. If then it is the paramount duty of neutral countries to avert the war. So what are the consequences of war, the results of war? There is an extermination of all life, including flora and fauna on our planet. All living beings will perish. And Russell places two choices before us, before the nations: continue warfare leading to annihilation of the human race, or the abolition of war. Here we can choose anyone. If we choose progress, knowledge and wisdom, happiness, we have to abolish the war.